In this section, we're going to be working with our iProduction manager. And for this one, we want to talk about how preparing food in smaller batches more often can really give you a great savings when it comes to food waste, as well as increasing food quality, making happier customers and ultimately happier chefs. In order to do this, we're going to go ahead and we're going to start our shopping cart over here on the iCombi Pro. To do that, I'm just going to go here to my programming mode. And then you can go ahead and you can filter through different ways. I want to find my programs, or if you want to find your shopping carts. Here we're going to go ahead and fire our shopping cart for Bistro R. You can see now that I get a ticket window up here, and in the ticket spot, I can go ahead and select the items that I want to cook. For this first one, we have our eggplant, we have our paninis, and we have French fries. So I'm going to go ahead and select my eggplant, and I'm going to place that just on the shelf anywhere that I like. And I'm going to take my French fries, we'll place those on the next shelf. So now you can see I get the indication here that the iProduction manager is going to preheat. Once it's preheated, it'll ask us to come back and load. We have a bunch of different accessories that we're going to be working with in this segment, and we have a ton of accessories across our entire line. For this one, we're actually going to be working with our grill and pizza tray. Here you can see we have our grill and pizza tray that I have our paninis on. It has a grilled side on one side, and if I flip it over, you can see here that we've got a nice smooth side, which makes a great baking hearth. But I found if I take two of our grill and pizza trays, I can simply push those together, give them a little squeeze there, and I've got a great panini press for making a batch of paninis. Here you can see we're working with our roasting and baking tray. The roasting and baking tray is a very thin aluminum pan that is Trilex coated, so it's non-stick. But being so thin and having this low edge here gives us a great airflow across this product here. We've dredged our eggplant with a little bit of oil here, and thanks to the quick heat transfer, we're going to get a beautiful fry on this eggplant using a minimal amount of oil and not having to go back and constantly shake that fryer or attend to a pan, making sure that we have the perfect temperature running. Over here, we're gonna be preparing our French fries in our combi fry basket. The combi fry basket is great for anything that you wanna get a great crisp on. I even use the combi fry basket when we're dehydrating items too. I can see now that the iCombi Pro is preheated, and it's giving me the indication on where to load the food. So I'll just pop open the door. We'll take our paninis. Close the door, and now we'll wait for the iCombi Pro to give us a signal to take them out. Well, we just got an order for a pizza, sausage and black olive. I'm gonna come on over, and you can see here that the items that are currently cooking, the time actually pauses. Let's me go ahead and load our pizza in. Close the door, and now I'm gonna select pizza, and just place that right there on rack 6. Now you can see we have French fries, our eggplant, we have our paninis going there, and we've just got a personal pizza that just went in. So we're getting the signal now that the paninis are done. You can see here that we got a checkered flag on the rack that they're cooking, which is rack 4. And you can also see here that we've got an LED blinking light only illuminating where rack 4 should be coming out. Pop open the door. The time for the other items that are cooking pauses so that I can remove my paninis. Close the door, and if the iCombi Pro wants to, using the iProduction Manager, it would go ahead and add any time back on necessary to get the appropriate cook time for the other items that we have going right now. But now you can see here that cheese is just starting to ooze out there. We've got a nice press, we've got our panini lines all ready to go there, and we've got a nice crunchy panini, all hot and ready for service or to go into the hot case getting ready for our lunch rush. So now I'm receiving indication that our pizza's done. Here we go there. Have our first pizza ready to go, but we also just got an order for chicken wings. Again, with our roasting and baking tray there, I can just go through and I can find my wings, and I'm gonna select those wings and I'm gonna place them right on rack number 1 while the other items are continuing to cook. And now we're receiving notification that the French fries are ready. Just a little season on those. And we got hot crispy fries ready to go. But we also have an order catering going out for 6 chicken parms and roasted asparagus. And now we've got the last indication there that our wings are done. Hot, crisp, and ready to go. So your iCombi Pro could be working in this fashion over and over and over throughout your entire meal service as tickets are coming in, or if your points of service are requiring more food, you can be able to serve them in small batches more often, very efficiently, and with a very, very small amount of space needed in your kitchen. If you'd like to talk more about the iProduction Manager or speak with one of the Rationale chefs, please contact us on the Rationale USA Chef Line.